Good day, folks. And today, a little different content than usual. We're going to have a look at a bike building legend, the daredevil Indian Larry. But first, we have a viewer submission. These are the quote-unquote middle-age white guys bikes from the middle of nowhere in Swift Current, Saskatchewan. This gentleman has three bikes. The first is a denim black 2013 Street Glide. The other two bikes you don't see around here too often. One is a 2008 Victory Arlen Ness Jackpot, and the other is a 2008 Victory Corey Ness Jackpot. The man likes his Victory bikes. But thanks for the picks, middle-aged white guy. And if you want to see your bike on the channel, send me a pic. My email address is in the description to this video. So, Indian Larry. There is so much you can say about this bike building legend. This man was a bike builder, stunt rider, and artist. He came to my attention on the Discovery Channel's Biker Build Off in the early 2000s. This is where a lot of people came to know him. Unfortunately, his untimely demise came way too early. So let's go for a little ride and go through the strange life and times of Indian Larry. Indian Larry, real name Lawrence DeSmet, was born on April 28, 1949 in New York City. He was an artistic kid and apparently quite mischievous. He was missing his little finger on his left hand, and depending on which story you believe, it was either because he blew it off making a bomb in his parents' basement, a bomb in which he apparently meant to blow up his school with, or it was removed due to building a rocket for the 4th of July. Anyway, later on, he learned how to weld, and as with his bike building, everything had to be perfect. Around the end of high school, he headed to California to be with his sister, and Larry began to experiment with drugs, and unfortunately, his sister was killed in 1971. He came back to his hometown, and to handle his grief, sunk deeper into addiction. He began to rob banks in order to keep up his drug addiction. At the age of 23, he was arrested after a robbery in 1972 and was sent to Sing Sing Prison on a 3-year sentence. While in jail, he earned his GED and took courses in mechanics and welding, and was released in 1976. It was in the mid-80s when Larry started to get recognized in the magazines as a bike builder. It was around this time that he began to be called Indian due to his flamed-out 1950 Indian Chief Chopper. He began to work in various motorcycle shops, but was still dealing with issues with alcohol and heroin. In 1991, he was admitted to Bellevue Hospital. He then was connected with an addiction program, and it wasn't until the late 90s that he was able to kick his habits. In the early 90s, Larry and others, such as Paul Cox, opened Psycho Cycles in New York's Lower East Side. Later, in 2000, he opened Gasoline Alley in Brooklyn. It was at these shops where he formed his signature style of chopper. Larry's bikes were stripped-down choppers, no front brake or fender, straight pipes, small gas tank, apes, usually with a kickstart and jockey shift. Now, one thing that particularly stuck out on his bikes was the stock rake. He was not into the long front end that became very popular in the early 2000s. This was done to keep the bikes nimble to get through the New York traffic and mountain canyons. And Larry was very much old school. He liked the hot rod culture of the 60s and was a big fan of the art of Ed Big Daddy Roth. He liked to use carburetors and never used a CNC machine. He liked pan heads and rigid frames. He considered himself a gearhead and wanted to see all the moving parts on a bike rather than cover them up. In 2003, Larry participated in his first of three biker build-offs on the Discovery Channel. I believe it was Billy Lane who convinced him to get involved with the show. Billy wanted to make sure that the world knew the bike building genius of Indian Larry. He built three bikes for the competitions: the Rat Fink, Wild Child, and his last, and in my opinion, best, the Chain of Mystery. Now, I have to make special mention of this bike, as it is really one of my favorites. This bike had a frame that had never been done before. The frame was, literally, made of chain. Using a heavy chain and a jig as a guide, the links were welded together. And you really have to check this bike out, because other than the possible dangerous nature of the frame, the rest of the bike is a work of art. Right from the engraved engine and dual carbs to the excellent leatherwork on the solo seat. Custom bike building really does not get any better. And the bike also held up, and he rode it through the show and to his last bike event. In 2004, Larry was living a happy life with his wife, Bambi, who he met in 1996. He was traveling around, attending events and shows, and his popularity was at its peak. In August, while filming his last biker build-off, he rode his Chain of Mystery bike to North Carolina for the Liquid Steel Classic and Custom Bike Series. Now, Larry was a longtime stunt rider, and one of his stunts was standing on the seat of his bike with his arms outstretched. It was something he had done many times over the years. But while performing the stunt on his bike, Grease Monkey, the front end began to wobble, the bike lost control, and Larry fell, hitting his head, sustaining a serious head injury. He was airlifted to hospital, but unfortunately passed away from his injuries on August 30, 2004. Larry's philosophy was to live in the moment. He adopted a question mark as his emblem to symbolize the mystery of life. He had a very noticeable tattoo on his neck that read, "In God we trust, vengeance is mine, saith the Lord, no fear." His friend Tim White may have said it best when he said Larry lived his art. There's no doubt about it. His life was art. He left a legacy of one of the best old school bike builders there's ever been. Now, if you want to check out more on Indian Larry, you can look at his biker build-off episodes, or there is a couple of books you can check out as well. One is called Indian Larry, Chopper Shaman, by Dave Nichols and Larry's wife, Andrea Bambi Cambridge. And the other is simply titled Indian Larry, and it is by his friend, Timothy White. So I will end this video with a quote from the man himself. "I don't know anything in life. I just show up and go with the flow. I'm not a religious person, but I'm a very spiritual person. Spirituality is instinctive, and I believe it is more of a Zen type thing. You stay in the moment and you'll get the right answers, the correct answers. Every motorcycle is always a spiritual experience. Choppers specifically are a very integral part of my spirituality. When I go out for a ride or something, I'm exactly in the moment. It's like meditation. I'm in the flow.